objectives. At the end of the course, the user will be able to understand the three levels of architecture, get knowledge about mapping of three levels, know database architecture. For effective decision making, an organization requires accurate, reliable data and efficient database system. One of the main aims of a database system is to provide users with an abstract view of data. It hides certain details of how data is stored and manipulated. To satisfy these needs, users need to develop an architecture for the database system. The database architecture is a framework in which the structure of the DBMS is described. It describes the identifiable components and their relation to one another structurally, and the functions of the various structural components interact to provide the overall functionality of the system as a whole. Components of a database system. The structure of a database is a data model, which is a collection of conceptual tools for describing data, data relationships, data semantics, and data constraints. Types of database system users that Navy users, application programmers, sophisticated users, specialized users. Query processor. It is one of the major components of a database in which the data is stored in table of rows and columns. It complements the storage engine, which writes data to and from storage media. DML, Data Manipulation Language, is a language that enables users to access or manipulate data. DDL, Data Definition Language, is a language for specifying the database schema and as well as other properties of the data. Storage Manager is a program module that provides the interface between the low-level data stored in the database and the application programs and queries submitted to the system. The Storage Manager is responsible for the following tasks: interaction with the file manager, efficient storing, retrieving, and updating of data. Data Dictionary. Information pertaining to the structure and usage of data contained in the database. The metadata are maintained in a data dictionary. Three levels of database architecture. Database architecture is classified into three levels: external level, conceptual level, internal level. External level is a user's view of a database. The external level consists of a number of different views of the database. The external view that includes those entities, attributes, and relationships which are available according to the user's interest. Entities, attributes, and relationships which user is not interested in may do exist in the database, but user would not be aware of that. Conceptual level. Conceptual level is the middle level in the three-tier architecture. It is also known as logical level because of abstraction deals with the logical structure of the entire database. It describes about the data stored in the database, the relationships among the data, and complete view of the user's requirement without any concern for the physical implementation. It hides the complexity of physical storage structures. The conceptual view is the overall view of the database, and it includes all the information that is represented in the database. Internal level. Internal level depicts the physical storage of database. Internal level is the lowest level of data abstraction. It is also called physical level because it deals with the physical representation of the database on the computer and also describes how the data is physically stored and organized on the storage medium. It interfaces with operating system to place data on the storage devices, retrieve the data, build the indexes, and so on. Internal level is concerned with two main processes, such as storage space and size allocation for data, data compression and data encryption techniques. This example shows the fields present in each level and how these fields are accessed by another level. Mappings. The process of transforming requests and results between the three levels, external, conceptual, internal, are called mapping. The DBMS software is responsible for mapping between three levels of schema. The three levels of database architecture are stored in the data dictionary. Data dictionary contains data about data. It means that it contains the actual database descriptions used by the computer. Each external schema is related to the conceptual schema by external or conceptual mapping. Conceptual schema is the hub of the architecture. Types of mapping. There are two types of mapping: external conceptual mapping, database administrator. Centralized control of the database is exerted by a person or group of persons. They are referred to as database administrator, DBA. DBA takes initiative to resolve problems and ensures that the application is running well with respect to the database. Thus, the DBA is responsible for overall control of the system at the technical level. Role of database administrator. Some of the tasks of DBA are: defining the conceptual schema, defining the internal schema, liaising with users, defining security and integrity constraints, defining dump or restore schemas, monitoring performance of database, defining the conceptual schema. It is the DBA's job to decide exactly what information is to be held in the database. In other words, to identify the entities of interest to the enterprise and to identify the information to be recorded about those entities. Defining the internal schema. The DBA must also decide how the data is to be represented in the stored database. This process is referred to as physical database design. Steps to be followed while defining internal schema. Initially, decide the requirement of user, that is, what data user want first. Secondly, decide how to represent it in storage. Liaising with users. It is the main task of DBA to liaise with users to ensure the availability of that data and also to write the necessary schemas for that data. In addition, the mapping between external schema and conceptual schema should be specified by DBA. Defining security and integrity constraints. Security and integrity constraints can be regarded as a part of the conceptual schema. The conceptual DDL must include facilities for specifying such constraints, defining dump or restore schemas. Once a firm or a company is committed to a database system, it becomes critically dependent on the successful operation of that system, so it is necessary to define schema. In some case, the damage to any portion of the database caused by human error, say, or a failure in the hardware or operating system should be fixed. Monitoring performance of database. The DBA is responsible for organizing the system in such a way as to get the performance that is best for the enterprise and for making the appropriate adjustments, that is tuning as requirements change. For example, it might be necessary to reorganize the stored database from time to time to ensure that performance levels remain acceptable. DBA services: backup and recovery, reports, monitoring and administration, monitoring, database planning, service plans. Entity relationship model. The entity relationship model defines the conceptual view of a database. It works around real-world entity and association among them. Example of ER model. At view level, ER model is considered good for designing databases. ER model is also defined as a logical representation of data in an enterprise schema, which represent the overall logical structure of the database. ER model provides the following three main semantic concepts to the designer: entity, attribute, relationship. Now, what is an entity? Entity. An entity is an object or a thing in the real world with an independent existence and that is distinguishable from other objects. Entities are represented by rectangular boxes. Rectangles are named with the entity set they represent. Symbol representation. Example. In this example, student will become a table in the database. The student table may contain name, roll number, etc. Attributes. Entities are represented by means of their properties called attributes. Each column of a table will have a name and a data type associated with it, which is called attribute. Symbol representation. Attributes are represented by means of ellipses. Every ellipse represents one attribute and is directly connected to its entity, that is rectangle. Describes various characteristics about an individual entity. Example. In this example, name is attribute, and it will be the columns in the table. Types of attributes. There are 5 types of attributes: simple attributes, composite attributes, derived attributes, single valued attributes, multi-valued attributes. Simple attributes. An attribute which cannot be broken down into smaller attribute is called simple attribute. Simple attributes have atomic values which cannot be divided further. Example. In this example, student's phone number is an atomic value of 10 digits. Composite attributes. Composite attributes are made of more than one simple attribute. Example. In this example, a student's complete name may have first name and last name. First name and last name are composite attributes. Derived attributes. The attributes which do not exist physically in the database is called derived attributes, but their values are derived from other attributes presented in the database. Symbol representation. Derived attributes are depicted by dashed ellipse. In this example, age is a derived attribute. It can be derived from birth date attributes. Single valued attributes. Single valued attributes contain a single value. Example. In this example, SSN, Social Security Number, is the single valued attribute. Multivalued attributes. Multivalued attribute can contain either a single valued or multiple values. It is represented by double ellipse. Example. In this example, phone number is a multi-valued attribute. A person can have more than one phone number. Relationship. The association among entities is called relationship. Example. In this example, student entity has relationship with phone number entity. Mapping cardinalities. Cardinalities refer to number of entities in one entity set which can be associated to the number of entities of another set via relationship set. There are 4 types of cardinalities: 1-to-1, 1-to-many, many-to-1, many-to-many. 1-to-1. One entity from entity set A, that is husband, can be associated with at most one entity of the entity set B, that is wife, and an entity in B, that is wife, is associated with at most one entity in A, that is husband. 1-to-many. One entity from entity set A, that is teacher, can be associated with more than one entities of entity set B, that is student, but from entity set B, that is student, one entity can be associated with at most one entity. Many to one. more than one entity from entity set A students can be associated with at most one entity of the entity set B teacher, but one entity from entity set B can be associated with more than one entity from entity set A. Many to many. More than one entity from A, that is students, can be associated with more than one entity from B, that is subjects, and vice versa. Three approaches of DBMS. Hierarchical data model, network data model, relational data model. Hierarchical data model. The hierarchical data model is represented by an upside down tree. The user perceives the hierarchical database as a hierarchy of segments. A segment is the equivalent of a file system's record type. It contains nodes connected by branches. The top node is called the root node or parent node. The parent can have no children. The parent can have one or more children. A hierarchical model can represent a one-to-many relationship between two entities where the two are respectively parent and child. A hierarchical path is a sequence of nodes starting from a root node and follows alternatively from a parent node to a child node. For example, person, staff, student is a path of hierarchical model. Advantages of hierarchical data model. Data sharing. Data security. Disadvantages of hierarchical data model. Inflexibility. Database management problems. Network data model. The network data model is similar to a hierarchical model, except that a record can have multiple parents. The network data model has three basic components, such as record types, data items. Links, that is set types. Network data model uses a lattice structure in which a record can have many parents as well as many children. this model, entities are organized in a graph in which some entities can be accessed through several paths. The network data model also consists of nodes and branches, but a child may have multiple parents within the network structure instead of being restricted to just one parent. Advantages of network data model. Facilitating more relationship types. Data independence. Superior data access. Database integrity. Simplicity. Disadvantages of network data model. Not user-friendly. System complexity, absence of structural independence, relational data model. A relational database, RDB, is organized by tables which contains a collective set of multiple data sets. RDB is derived from the mathematical function concept of mapping data sets and was developed by Edgar F. Codd at IBM in 1977. In the relational database, each file is perceived as a flat file, that is, a two-dimensional table called relations consisting of many lines, that is, records, each record having key and non-key data items. Tables communicate and share information which facilitates data searching ability, organization and reporting. Properties of relational table. Values are atomic. Each row is unique. Column values are of the same kind and have a unique name. Advantages of relational data model. Ease of design, implementation, maintenance and uses, flexibility and powerful query capability, structural independence, simplicity. Disadvantages of relational data model. Hardware overheads. Easy to design capability leading to bad design. Summary. In this class, users have learnt about three levels of architecture, mapping and its cardinalities.